I'm so excited to be down here at Harbor Front Center. We're going to have a lot of fun here today because I'm going to be talking about all the different craft studios and talent workshops that people can take here anytime during the year with Melanie Egan, the head of the craft department. How are you, Melanie?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm feeling crafty.
Great.
So is it true that anybody from Toronto can come down here and take a course taught by an artist in residence?
We teach adult courses, so you have to be 18 years and over. But because we're an open studio, the public can come down at any time and see any of the activity that's going on here. So it is a way of participating as well.
So even if you think that you don't have that artistic eye, you can stand in the gallery and watch it happen?
Absolutely, absolutely.
So what are some of the courses that are taking place here?
We have textile and fiber courses. We have ceramic courses, pottery courses, jewelry making courses, and glass blowing courses as well.
Glass blowing has to be for the more adventurous.
I think it has to be for the brave of heart, but if you like a little bit of heat, a little bit of sweat, it's a fantastic thing to do, fantastic thing to do.
So do you already have to have some basic foundation in the crafts that you've just described to take these courses?
No, we take every course is a beginner's course, so you just have to have enthusiasm, and most people have that, and as you say, wanting to have fun, wanting to learn something new.
I think it's so fascinating that in Toronto these courses are taught by artists in residence. Can you explain that program?
It's part of their career development and professional development. When they come into the studio, there's a number of resources that we offer them, and teaching classes is one thing, so that they can get the experience teaching as well. So it's good for their CV, and it's also good for Harbor Front Center.
So who can apply to be an artist in residence?
Any graduate from a recognized design, art, craft or design university or college can't apply, and that's right across the country. We have artists in the studio from across the country.
What an amazing opportunity. I think that's great. And we've got Adriana here. How are you, Adriana?
I'm good.
You teach what kind of classes here?
I teach beginner and intermediate jewelry classes.
Beautiful. What are you working on?
I'm just working on a ring right now. It doesn't have the stone in it yet, so it's just the ring and the stone separate.
Beautiful.
Yep.
So when people come to your classes, are they enthusiastic or are they nervous?
Most people are pretty excited, maybe nervous at first, but they catch on pretty fast and everybody leaves making something really nice.
I hope so. My fingers would be crossed. And as you, as an artist, how rewarding is this for your career to be teaching these classes?
It's rewarding. It's nice to be able to teach the things that I learn to new people and see how excited they get when they make something themselves.
I'm going to let you get back to that ring because I want to see the finished product, hopefully, okay, before I leave today. It's so gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks. Melanie, I'm wondering, this has got to be such a busy place during the fall with school season starting and lots of kids and parents coming to check out what you do here. But how busy is it in the summer?
It's incredibly busy in the summer. We still have that component coming down because we have all these camps and children and tourists and people who are just strolling by, going to the lake, and they come into the building and see all this excitement going on. And sometimes it's so clogged down the corridor, particularly in front of glass. Regardless of how, you know, warm it is or cool outside, there's always a sort of avid gallery of people watching what's going on in the studios. It's a very busy, very active time.
That sounds crazy, but you can't have glass blowing in the summer heat. Am I right?
Well, we do. Our artists blow glass in the summertime. We do suspend our public classes during that time simply because if it does get to be like 30 or 35 degrees outside that Toronto can get, at sometimes it's awfully hot in our studio. We actually suspend activity if it gets that hot.
Mike, so. Well, I would think people are so excited to see those beautiful pieces of glass happen,
yes,
they could wilt from the excitement.
Yep. Yes, exactly.
And speaking of excitement, this has got to be one of the most popular courses.
Yes, indeed.
So what are we doing? Is this a ceramic studio now on this side?
Yes, we're in the ceramic studio with Roseanne Jolie. She's throwing a basic cylinder pot on the pottery wheel, and these are the kinds of courses that we teach, the basic pottery courses.
And if you, let's say, mastered it the way our artist is doing right here, which is amazing, could you then go on to an intermediate level? How does it work?
Yes, you can do that. And what's really interesting is sometimes somebody will take a class in our studio and actually then go on to college and university to study ceramics.
That's
and
so
we've
exciting.
Actually had people come back to apply, and their very first experience of pottery has been at Harbor Front Center. So that's kind of exciting.
So you're responsible for people shifting gears and changing
yes,
careers.
Yes, yes.
And oftentimes it's a second career, which is really interesting. So,
wow. Yeah. Well, I mean, this is the beginning stages, literally, of possibly someone's imagination blossoming into a career.
Indeed.
And then tell me a little bit about the work that's on display. Is this students' work? Because it seems really sophisticated up in the display cases.
All the exhibition spaces have work by professional artists. We mm-hmm. don't actually show student work. So along this particular corridor above the craft department is an exhibition done by actually Adriana in our jewelry studio. Those wonderful rings that you wanted to see finished. There's a bunch of them up there.
Gorgeous.
And a recent graduate from our program, Amanda McCaver, who was a textile artist. So, yeah.
Now, it begs the question, Melanie, what did you make to start your own artistic career?
I actually started making jewelry. I studied jewelry a long, long time ago and actually was in our metal studio about 25 years ago.
So if students come to take classes, are they liable to see you kind of put your little finger into something?
No, I'm more at the artistic directing, administrative directing end at this point. So that's how I get my creative kicks, I guess.
I would imagine this is a really difficult temptation to resist, though, because I think everyone makes it look like you could start anything. You could really do it.
I think that's the beauty of skill and refinement and elegance. The artists in the studios make it look so easy, and this comes from years and years and years of applying themselves, as I say, skill, but ideas and concepts and that kind of thing. So I think it is wonderful that the public can come by and just sort of see the creative spirit in motion, you know, so to speak. So.
Well, that's just one of the many fantastic things that go on at Harbourfront and really in Toronto, that you can have a piece of art inspire you to take a class, maybe change your life.
Absolutely.
Thanks so much,
You're
Melanie.
Very welcome.
Thanks for joining us here, but stay tuned because we have so much more summer fun on Summertime Daytime when we get back. I might have to put my finger in that pottery wheel.